Biology of the Komodo Dragon. Scientists were mystified when Komodo dragons were found by Dutch explorers in the early 20th century. It was not until researchers fully studied the creatures that they were able to understand just how unique and amazing they are. These creatures, the largest living lizards, have many interesting biological adaptations that have helped them thrive in the harsh environment of the Lesser Sunda Islands in Indonesia, where they are found. Komodo dragons, which can grow up to 10 feet and weigh up to 350 pounds, are from the monitor lizard family. There are over 3,000 species of monitors in the world, and they can be found on every continent except Antarctica. However, what sets these creatures apart from every other lizard on Earth is their impressive size, strength, and the fact that they are venomous. Every species has biological characteristics to help it survive and thrive in its natural environment. The combination of these characteristics together is known as the creature's biology. The biology of a Komodo dragon is what will be explored in this video. Every aspect of their lives, from birth to when they are juveniles to when they develop into adults, has been perfectly adapted to meet the challenges of their environment. From simple genetic coding within the DNA computer program to their complex feeding behaviors, every moment of a Komodo dragon's life has been optimized to increase its chances of survival. This makes them the perfect topic for exploration in the field of biology. Visible characteristics of the Komodo dragon. The Komodo dragon is the largest living species of lizard. It has a heavily muscled body and tail, and a very sturdy, strong, and straight leg. Komodo has a very special body shape. It has a long neck and a tail, and a flat head with a rounded snout with strong jaws. It also has long, sharp, and serrated teeth. Komodos have three different kinds of teeth. The first kind of teeth is located at the side of its jaws, which is used to tear up flesh twisted off the dead bodies by the other Komodos. The second kind of teeth is found at the bottom jaw, which is used for biting and for pulling big pieces of meat off from its prey. The last kind of teeth is the sharp and long teeth, which are located at the edge of its jaws. Its tongue is also pink and fork-like. This special design of the mouth makes the Komodo very skillful at hunting, as it has a very big and flexible mouth that it could open very wide to swallow a big piece of flesh or even a big goat in just a few gulps. The loose skin and the heavy armor, which is made by bones, provide protection to Komodo against bites resulting from a fight, as its skin is very hard to cut through. The stomach of the Komodo is elastic and could extend to many times greater than its original size. As Komodo has a habit of eating too much at a time, this flexibility of the stomach makes it possible for the Komodo to store and digest all it's eaten, and it only needs to eat once a month. Also, the stomach of Komodo contains a certain kind of acid that helps to kill any kind of pathogenic bacteria contained in the meat. This is important, as Komodo's saliva contains about 50 different kinds of pathogenic bacteria. Therefore, in order not to infect itself, a Komodo normally has to finish up a whole piece of meat in one go without leaving any pieces. Every time after the meal, the Komodo will find a place to have a good rest for a few days until it is hungry again. After finishing the digestion, it will defecate a mass of feces in gray color. Komodos have good eyesight, even though it has been suggested that their visions are in black and white only. Despite its poor auditory, Komodo has a very good sense of smell, which is the key tool for its hunting. The olfactory bulb in Komodo's brain is used to process the smells and is about the size of a small tomato. When there is a dead prey nearby, Komodos are able to smell and locate the prey even over a few kilometers. However, they have to rely on their nostrils to breathe as well. To maximize the airborne smells they could detect, they will flick their tongue immediately after each inhalation. By doing this on a regular basis, Komodos can picture what they are smelling and therefore trace the source of the smell more effectively. Unique hunting and feeding behavior. The Komodo dragon has a very specific way through which it gets its food. First of all, this kind of lizard mainly spends its time searching for prey. It is very rare that large lizards, such as the Komodo dragon, come with such an interesting hunting method. These lizards mainly walk for several miles to search for prey. It has been said that the Komodo dragon has venomous saliva. Actually, there are almost 50 strains of bacteria in its saliva. Whenever the prey is bitten by the lizard, within a day the venom, the saliva, mainly works, and the prey becomes very weak. Finally, the healing process never happens completely, and the prey dies. After a successful hunt, some Komodo dragons might eat up to 80% of their body weight. They mainly like to eat young or small animals, birds, pigs, and so on. The large lizard normally avoids hunting for large prey as it requires huge energy. Researchers believe that the dragons may go into a bit of shock due to the amount of food that is being ingested. And the successful hunting takes most of the daytime. Specifically, the large lizards often hunt in starvation, mainly in very hot weather. This mainly causes a higher success rate of hunting for the dragons. Also, they do have a relatively slower metabolic rate, which is the main reason that the lizards eat only about 12 times a year. Some researchers noticed that quite often the small animals and birds escaped by running into the water. Due to the heavy body weight, the large lizard is relatively slower in the water than on land. Also, the large lizards are good at climbing. This gives us the conclusion that when the dragons hunt carcasses, they mostly use their tails to sneeze. It means that a violent thrashing through the mouth takes place and sends out a spray from the liquids in the abdomen. Through this action, the lizards can avoid internal and toxic bacteria, as well as external flies. Reproduction and life cycle of the Komodo dragon. An adult female lays her eggs deep inside a natural cavity or burrow, typically on a hillside. The female will perform a series of approaches and then dig test holes to judge the conditions. She continues to construct and improve the nest mound by digging earth, leaves, and debris using her powerful limbs and feet. When she finds the right place, she will lay a clutch of about 15 to 30 eggs and remain in the nest chamber for around the next 3 months, guarding them vigilantly. It is estimated that the eggs will take around 7 to 8 months to develop and hatch. The female does not assist her offspring in hatching. They must rely on the egg tooth, which they use to slit and tear the thickened surface membrane. Small juveniles tend to stay in the surrounding area of the nest for the first few days, until they muster up the courage to leave the vicinity and climb into the safer, higher branches. Once they have reached the age of 1 to 3 years, the young dragons are normally forced to leave the vicinity around the main nest, in order to protect themselves from aggressions from larger dragons, or even from their mothers. The lifespan of a Komodo dragon is around 20 to 50 years. However, this can be greatly affected by disease or sudden changes in climate. In captivity, the species has been known to live for over 50 years. The oldest Komodo dragon in captivity is recorded at 56 years. Conservation and threats to the Komodo dragon. The current status of the Komodo dragon is vulnerable. Vulnerable means that there is a high risk of extinction in the wild. There are a number of reasons why the Komodo dragon is vulnerable, one of the main reasons being that their habitats are being destroyed. Their habitat is being used for development, and the local people need to use the land for their crops, so they're cutting down the trees in the forests. The Komodo dragons and the deer that they feed on are both losing their habitat because the trees are being destroyed. Another reason is that the local people are sometimes killing the deer or other animals in the national parks. Because the Komodo dragons feed on these animals, they are then left with less to eat, and then become more vulnerable. I also think that people don't do enough to protect this species. Maybe they need to learn more about these reptiles and understand how important it is to protect them and their habitat. One way that people are trying to protect the Komodo dragon is in the national parks in Indonesia. Wardens are employed to protect these animals. These are the people who look after protected animals, such as the Komodo dragon and their habitats. They also look after the national parks and make sure that people come to these parks to enjoy the wildlife and the beauty of the countryside, but not to harm the national parks or protected animals. This is a great chance to help these giant lizards, and I hope the people who visit or live close to the national parks understand how important it is to help protect these vulnerable creatures. We have a responsibility to protect and respect these giant lizards and their habitats for future generations.